Welcome, my dear learners. This video is on Grade 2, Chapter 8, Drawing and Painting Using Microsoft Paint. So, Chapter 7 was Tux Paint. You have learned and also enjoyed a lot drawing in Tux Paint. So, today in this video, I'm going to teach you how to use Microsoft Paint. Now, what is Microsoft Paint? Paint is a program or an application that helps us make and color beautiful drawings on a computer. It has many useful tools that can be used to make wonderful drawings easily. So let us first learn how to open Paint. Okay, so in Windows operating system, if you have Microsoft Office, the application, Paint application, comes inbuilt with Microsoft Office. So, in the search box, in the taskbar, can you see at the bottom, this horizontal bar is known as taskbar. And you have a search box over here. You have to type Paint, P-A-I-N-T. So can you see the first application over here? This is Paint. To open Paint, click on it and wait. So the Paint window has opened now. Now first we are going to learn about parts of the Paint window. First is Quick Access Toolbar. Can you see my mouse pointer on the left corner top? This is the Quick Access Toolbar. It contains buttons to quickly save the drawing that we have made and to make a new drawing and so on. Next is the ribbon. Can you see my mouse pointer? Below the Quick Access Toolbar is the ribbon. It has three tabs, File tab, Home tab and the View tab. File tab. Clicking on the File tab opens a list of options for creating new drawing. Then for opening the existing. Existing means the drawing which you have already made. You can also open it again. And to save the drawing you have made right now. Next is the Home tab and View tab over here. Clicking on this tabs display various tools and options that help us work in Paint. Can you see the white area over here? This is known as the drawing area. This is the area where we draw and color the pictures. Now, everybody pay attention, because we are going to learn the different tools that are used for drawing in the Paint. So, Paint tools. Can you see the tools? These are the Paint tools over here. First tool is a pencil tool. So, I'm clicking on a pencil tool. My mouse cursor has changed to a pencil. Just like we use a pencil to draw on a plain sheet, we can use a pencil to draw freehand in Paint. Let us use this tool to draw a tree. Click on the pencil tool in the tools group. Click size to choose the line thickness. Can you see size option over here? So to choose the line thickness, you choose one size. I will choose a big size from here. Click on color one. This is color one, color two. So first click on color one, then choose a color in the colors group. So you can choose any color. So we are drawing the tree. So first we will take brown color to draw the stem of the tree. Now to start drawing, move the pointer to the drawing area. Keep the left mouse button pressed. Drag the mouse to draw a tree. So first I will draw the stem of the tree like this. What you have to do, you have to keep the left mouse button pressed and drag the mouse in whatever shape you want to draw. So in this way, I have drawn the stem of the tree. Next is, now I want to draw the upper part, the leaves. So I will select the green color. And again, by pressing the left mouse button of my mouse, I am dragging it to draw the upper part of the tree like this. Okay. Fill with color tool. Next is, second is fill with color tool. After the picture is drawn, it can be filled with different colors using the fill with color tool. To fill the colors in the drawing, you use fill with color tool. You can use this tool to fill colors in any closed shape. Let us color the picture of the tree drawn earlier. So selecting the fill with color tool, click on color 1 and select a color from the colors group. I will select this green color. Now click the mouse inside the area which needs to be filled here. And can you see the tree is filled with green color. Now we want to color the stem also. So I will select brown color and click on the stem wherever I want the color. Next is text tool. Can you see this A? Third one is the text tool. Used to type a message in a drawing. Let us add the text to about drawing. Click on the text tool. Drag the pointer to the drawing area where you want to add the text. Now if I click over here, I can add the text over here. A text tab gets added next to the view tab. Can you see one more tab is added, that is text. Choose the style and size of the text in the font group. So you can select the size of your font. It is 48 over here. Can you see this box? This is font size. I will select the size 28. I will select the style of the font. These are the different styles of the font. And now when I will write plant more and more trees. You can also change the color of this. Select your text. Click on color 1 and you can select any color from here for your text, and the text has changed to that color. And now when you click anywhere outside, you have the text on your drawing area. Next is the erase tool. Erase tool helps us to rub any part of your drawing. So left click on the erase tool. Okay, this is the eraser tool. Okay, now left click on the eraser tool in the left tools group. Click the size. Okay, now you have to select the size from your size of the eraser. Move now and select the bigger size. Move the pointer to the drawing area. Keeping the left mouse button pressed, drag the mouse over the part of the picture that needs to be erased. If I need to erase the stem of the tree like this, I just have to press my left mouse button and keep moving my eraser like this. It has deleted the stem of my tree. Next is the brush tool. The brush tool can be used to draw lines and curves with different looks and effect. Click on the brushes down arrow. Can you see brushes? Click on the down arrow. A list of available brushes gets displayed. Click on the brush of your choice. These are the different brush. Brush, calligraphy brush 1, calligraphy brush 2. This is a oil brush. This is a air brush. This is crayon, marker, natural pencil, and watercolor brush. You can select any brush of your choice. I will select the calligraphy brush 1. Click on the color 1 and select any color of your choice. I will select red color. Move the pointer to the drawing area and keep the left button, mouse button pressed. Drag to draw the lines using the selected brush. Now using the calligraphy brush, I am drawing the line. Again, I will select first brush. Then I can select the size also. And this is the first brush. Calligraphy 2 brush. This is the calligraphy 2 brush. Airbrush, like this. This is a oil brush. This is a crayon. So these are the different types of brush. This is a marker which you can use to draw attractive and beautiful pictures. This is a pencil. And the last one is a watercolor brush. I hope you have understood all this. Okay. Next, we are going to learn is about the shape tool. Before that, we will erase everything. Click on eraser. Click on size. Select the most big eraser. And this way, wherever you want to erase, you just move your mouse pointer. To increase the size of your eraser more, click on your keyboard keys, control plus plus key, to increase the size of your eraser like this. And now it is becoming easy for me to erase. On the same page, I'm going to show you how to draw different shapes in a paint tool. Yes, we have erased everything. Now, shapes tool. Shapes group has many. Can you see? This is the shape group. It is having many tools that can be used to draw various shapes. Now, to draw the shapes, click on any shape in the shapes group. I can click on any shape. Click size and select the size. Click on color 1 and you can select any color from the color palette. Keep the left mouse button pressed and drag the mouse to draw the shape. This way you can draw the shape. Okay, you can also write in the shape, such as click on text, click inside it, and you can write this is a You can write anything, for example, SWS, like this. Okay. Next is shapes with outline and fill color. A shape with different outline and fill color can also be drawn. When you draw such shape, choose the following colors. Okay, now you can click on home, select a different shape, a nice shape, then to fill this color and to give a nice outline. Okay, fill the color 1 with the outline color and click on color 2 for the color to be filled inside. Okay, and I can choose any color from here and I can draw like this to draw a filled color, but this way it will not come. Now to start, I am going to tell you some shapes to fill the shape. Okay, click on color 2 and choose a color. Then click on outline. Can you see? This is the outline. Click on outline and select a type of outline you want. So from here, I will select. There are no outline, solid outline, crayon, marker, oil, natural pencil, watercolor. So I'll click on crayon and fill color type. I will select any. I'll first select a crayon. And now moving the mouse pointer in the drawing area, you can draw a figure like this, a filled figure. You can draw the stars like this, outline as oil, then fill color as watercolor, and color 1 we'll take red, color 2 to fill the color we'll take pink. We'll draw the star like this. We'll take different star, then the outline as marker and fill color as crayon, and we will take color 1 as orange and color 2 as yellow, and we will draw one more figure like this. Hope you understood how to draw a shape with outline and fill color. Next is drawing a curve tool. Use of the curve tool. This is a curve tool in the shape. Click on the curve tool in the shapes group. Choose a line style from outline, line thickness from size. Okay, you can select the line thickness from size over here. From the outline, you can select what type of line. I'll select solid size. Then you can select the line color from here. I'll select maroon as color 1. And I will draw a curve. First, draw a straight line like this. Okay. So there are two ways to draw a curve line. First is click on the point outside the line where you want the line to curve. If I want my line to curve over here, I will click over here and it will form a curve. The line will curve in that direction. And one more curve I want, and in this way I can curve a line. And the other way is, first take a curve tool, draw a straight line, and then click on any point on the line and keep the left mouse button pressed. Drag the pointer in the direction in which you want the line to curve. This way, here if I want the curve, press the mouse button and drag it to however you want the curve. Next, one more curve, just drag it however you want to curve and leave it. This will form a curved line. So using the above step, you can curve the line only 2 times. Next you're going to learn is a polygon tool. A polygon tool, a triangle has 3 sides. Rectangle has 4 sides. This is a triangle. This is a rectangle. Diamond has 4 sides. This is a diamond. Pentagon has 5 sides. This is a pentagon. And hexagon has 6 sides. This is a hexagon. All the shapes are present in the shape. What if you want to draw a shape having more than 6 sides? So you use a polygon tool. Click on the polygon tool in the shapes group. This is a polygon tool over here in the shapes group. Choose color 1. And color 2 for the polygon. Choose the line style, fill style, and the line thickness. Select the line thickness, fill style. Move the pointer to the drawing area. Left click and drag the mouse to draw a line. So I'll just draw first one line. Click at the point where the next line of the figure should end. So I just click where I want the next line. I want the next line over here. Repeat step 5 for various sides of the figure. Double click to stop drawing. Now until how many sides I want, I will repeat the step. This is another side. This is another side. One more. One more. One more. And wherever you want to finish, you double click. So I'll double click over here. So I have formed a figure with the sides 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Same way, using a polygon tool, you can draw any number of figure with any number of sides. Now, if you draw a beautiful drawing, you will have to save it if you want to see it afterwards. You can save your beautiful drawing in the computer so that you can open it for later use. When a new drawing is saved for first time, the name is given called the file name. The steps to save a drawing are: click on the file tab, click on save option, the save as dialog box will appear. Click on save. Type the file name in the file name box. Type a suitable name. You can select a suitable folder to save your picture. Okay, I'll write over here MS Paint. Click on save. Your picture is saved. You have given the name. Can you see on the title bar top where my mouse pointer is? It displays the name of your drawing, that is MS Paint. Afterwards, now when you have saved your drawing, if you have made any changes after saving and you want to save again, you again go on file and click on save. All the changes will be saved. Now, opening a saved document. To open an already saved drawing, click on the file tab. Click on open option. An open dialog box appears. Now, search for the drawing that you have already created. I have it in my third folder. So here are some drawings that I have already created. So I can just select it and I can click on open button to open the file. So this is the drawing which I have already created using Microsoft Paint. To open a new document, if you want to draw something new and to open a new document, click on file and click on open. Click on file and click on new. A new document is open to draw a new painting. Now there are some tips for you. To save a drawing, click on Ctrl plus S. Opening a saved drawing, click on Ctrl plus O. Opening a new paint window, you have to click on Ctrl plus N from your keyboard. I hope you have understood how to draw and how to use different tools in Microsoft Paint. Okay, so students, keep drawing and keep enjoying Microsoft Paint.